Chapter 3, Stonehenge Phase 2. The Avenue. When the waters started to subside, the builders of Stonehenge had an engineering problem, how to cope with the lower groundwater table, to allow the Stonehenge moat to remain full. Firstly, as we have already illustrated, by lining the Stonehenge moat with a clay waterproofing, so it acted like a dew pond, and in this chapter we shall go into detail of how they built a new earthwork called the Avenue with its own moat, which brought the waters closer to the monument's bathing moat. Processional walkway. The Avenue was created sometime after the original moated henge, once the original Mesolithic groundwater and shoreline lowered towards the new Neolithic groundwater level. When the water levels fell, the builders faced two problems. Firstly, the original mooring could no longer accept boats or cargo, so a new entrance was required. Secondly, the moat would no longer fill as it did in Mesolithic times, as the water table had dropped by about 10 meters. As we have seen from the excavations by Hawley in the 1920s, the builders had added a liner similar to those found in other Mesolithic period constructions like dew ponds also found in this area. The reason for the liner would have been to retain the water that accumulated by the natural rain and seasonal high tides that would have replenished the moat. It is entirely plausible that insufficient or infrequently water levels were a common occurrence during the late Mesolithic. Therefore, if they wished to continue the bluestone treatments, an alternative method to fill the moat needed to be found. The Avenue is quite curious, and excavations have revealed its ongoing development, as indicated by the post holes dotted down its entire length. This clearly shows that it adapted over a long period to match the retreating shoreline in the Neolithic period, which lasted over 2,500 years. Moreover, the physical construction of the Avenue earthwork shows the incorporation of water features. The southern ditch is much shallower than the northern ditch of the Avenue. This is because the water lies on the southern side of the Avenue and does not need extra depth to fill the southern ditch evenly, while the northern ditch is further away from the water, and on a gradient. For it to fill evenly to the same depth of water as the southern ditch, the northern ditch would therefore need to be 10% deeper. Furthermore, this extra depth to one side of the monument can also be seen in the main ditch of Stonehenge, as the main ditch corresponding to the Northern Avenue ditch is also 10% deeper. Further evidence of this shoreline can be seen in the post holes found in the Avenue. These post holes do not make sense.
You have been watching a small part of the Prehistoric Britain DVD documentary called The Stonehenge Enigma. The full 3-hour DVD is available on Amazon, as well as all 3 trilogy books.